What is hypofraction radiation therapy of the breast? Let me share with you some important thoughts on this subject. Hypofraction radiation therapy of the breast means doing whole breast radiation therapy, giving a little larger dose each day and doing it over a much shorter time period. Typical regular whole breast radiation therapy is done in 5 weeks, and then often there's 1 week of a boost therapy done after that, where hypofraction radiation therapy is concluded in 3 weeks, and it can be done again with or without the boost, which generally adds another week. Now, hypofraction radiation therapy has been very standard in a way of treating breast conservation cases in Canada, the UK, and other areas around the world. And previously here at Breast Cancer Answers, we've actually reported on outcome studies that show that hypofraction radiation therapy is equally as effective as whole breast radiation therapy, whether you do the boost therapy or not. The cosmetic results are the same, and of course the time is shortened considerably when it's down to 3 weeks of the whole breast radiation therapy. Now, an important study was published near the end of 2014 in the Journal of the American Medical Association on this very subject of hypofraction radiation therapy. It came from the Department of Radiation Oncology at the University of Pennsylvania. They looked at 14 health plans from around the United States and looked at the category of patients who are typically eligible for hypofraction radiation therapy. This includes women who are age 50 or older, no history of chemotherapy, and typically smaller breasted, A cup, B cup, smaller C cup sized breasts. In this study, they also looked at women who may have had prior chemotherapy and who are under age 50. Now, the results I thought were quite surprising and, for me at least, disappointing. Between 2008 and 2013, of all the women who could have had whole breast radiation therapy and met the typical criteria, in fact, only 35% of them received hypofraction therapy. And in the group that was pushing the envelope a little bit, where there had been prior chemotherapy and under age 50, it was only around 21%. I find this disappointing because, let's face it, hypofraction radiation therapy is more convenient. There's less of a treatment burden for the patient. Actually, the costs of doing it are lower. And yet, we find that there's such a little adoption of this in the United States. If you are a patient who's had a lumpectomy, you meet the typical criteria of being 50 or older and not having had chemotherapy, and you're a smaller breast size, you should be asking your radiation oncologist if you're going to be receiving hypofraction radiation therapy. It is equally as effective, a shorter time period, and lower costs. Do you know that not every breast cancer patient needs chemotherapy? Now there's a way to decide if chemotherapy will benefit you based on the unique biology of your tumor. To learn more about the Oncotype DX test and how to discuss it with your doctor, click this button.